Afghanistan, we can talk for hours, I guess. My thought on that is that when August 21, 2017 strategy was announced, it spoke of conditions-based approach of the United States. And many amongst us thought that what it meant was that they were looking for a military solution, which is that we will create a condition where the United States is satisfied that there is no longer a challenge and a threat by any militant insurgents or non-states. With 43% territory still not in the control of the government forces, with Daesh entering 9 provinces, with all the as many as 20 recognized terrorist outfits operating in that huge place, it has become very clear that the military solution is not a possibility. And if it had any chance, it could have come by in 2011, when we had a peak number of forces. In 2017, 3 times more bombs and munitions have been dropped in Afghanistan than in 2016, according to U.S. And the net result is not there. And that is itself 4/5 of the peak in 2011. So I think the things are moving towards peace and reconciliation option. But I don't go beyond that. On whether Pakistan can develop relations with Russia and others at the expense of its relations with the United States, I agree with Salman that relations with the United States are very important, and we should have good relations with the United States. It doesn't mean that we should compromise on our sovereignty or on our interests. But we need to have good relations with the United States. Pakistan needs a balanced relationship with both China and the United States, as well as Russia and others. I don't think there should be a zero-sum game here. But of course, you can always prioritize. As he said, in his view, the main agenda should be development, so we need to see where the development agenda can be pursued. So if we know the parameters and the role there should be prioritized, but does it mean that elsewhere we should have hostile relationship? No. I don't think so. And I agree with him also that India tried to isolate us by postponing the SAARC summit and creating this troika of east-west pressure on Pakistan. But in the process, actually, the realignments that are appearing are actually India rather than us. So it's a matter of keeping your hope and faith in your own country, its resources, and then the future belongs to you. Yes, challenges are enormous, but challenges are very big. I agree that we should be very clear in what we want to achieve.